Hey, what is this? Oh, there it is. Whoa. Hey, welcome to the Blue Garden. Guess what? Look, I'm not using this. So let me record me recording me with my new camera. There we go. So there it is. All right, so hopefully you can hear me. I got a boom mic on that, and I see myself now. I got a flip phone, so hopefully everything will come out better and get better views. Give me the opportunity to learn the camera. All right, so it isn't going to be all perfect. So today what I have over here is a new project. You guys seem to like the tools, so I'll be explaining some tool work and doing. So today, like I said, this is Jay from Skunk Works, and some of you might recognize me from my other channel, which is at the Blue Garden 2060. And I explain over there my condition, and you know, I retired 3 times. I got a bad hip, and health-wise, it's not good. So what I'm doing here is a ramp, wheelchair ramp for the front entrance, and I'm gonna need it. Like I said, I got a bad hip. It's bone on bone, no more cartridge. So I got that. And so I'm making a ramp here, so I'm gonna show you how to use some tools, the name of the tools, and how to do some stuff. Now, some of you guys might already know a few of these things, but hey, there's a lot of you guys that don't know, and you'll be the lucky ones that stay tuned and learn something. All right, so let's grab and set up our first project here into this operation. All right, welcome. Don't know if it's on. Yes. All right, welcome. So here we got this stuff here. We're gonna have to drill this, so we can attach some leg screws so we can fasten it together. All right, so let me show you here what we got. All right, so here we got our wood. You see this? And we're gonna drill these in here. So this one gets attached to the bottom one. Right now they're just glue on, and we need to find the right tool to drive this in here. This, you can see, that's a hex. A hex has 6 eyes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's a hexagon. So now we need to get a socket driver, socket this size, to drive it in there. Now, a lot of you are wondering, all right, so what size head is that? And a lot of you want to know, if you're experienced and been doing this for years, you can just look at it and say, that that's about a 3/8. That's 375 in decimal. Or 716, which is 437 and a half. These converting fractions into decimals, like I said, you take the numerator divided by the denominator and you'll get your decimal fraction. If you've been doing this for decades, you memorize them, and it's very easy to convert them. So that's why you hear me saying the fraction and the decimal so quickly. But for those of you that don't know how to convert that quickly, you'll use a tool like this. All right, so this is called a vernier caliper, dial calipers, all right? It's a dial. The vernier It's the one without the dial. It just has numbers that you have to line up. So don't get those two confused. This is a dial caliper, okay? Because it has a dial. The veneer doesn't have the dial. All right, so basically, you get it. Hopefully you can see it here. I can't see it. This is that's 556, 556,000. So you gotta convert that to the nearest one. I said it was 3/8, so I was way off, too small. So the one that would fit this is probably 9/16, which is 562, all right? So see, it's showing me 555. The nearest fraction to that size is 9/16, which is 562. So that socket would take a socket of that size, 9/16. So to confirm that, which I know is pretty true, we go here. Hopefully you can see it. Nope, I gotta go utilities. Get calculator. All right, so it's, I said it's 9/16. 9 divided by 16 should be 562. 562.5. You see that? So that's the information I'm giving you is correct. All right, so now, again, what size diameter is this? Because we're going to need to drill a hole into our parts right here. So we're going to need to know what size hole. Now, you don't want to do a hole that's too big, or you don't want to do a hole that's too small. So you can see here the thread, and then the material in between the thread is called a pitch diameter. So you use your same calipers here, measure your pitch diameter, and that is 262. Now, 262, a good size there is a 1/4 inch, 250. So you have to use a 1/4 inch drill, and that will only leave you about, that looks like 10-15 thousand, which is a 164 tightness. So that would be great. Use a 1/4 inch drill, 250. Do you see how that works? Now, up here, here's where it gets a little more tricky. See, this is 365. 365 right here, the shoulder. So that means that 250 would jam up here and it won't go through. So, right here, 365, what's the nearest fraction to 365? That's why you gotta learn your fractions and your decimals. 365 and 375 is 3/8. See, 375 will give you the enough clearance there. It'll give you 5/10,000 clearance. So that's what I'm saying. You gotta learn your fractions and your decimals. Alright. So here let's talk about our drills. Alright. Now the drills come in many different styles and varieties. What I have here is a jobbler set. This is a jobbler, all right? That's what they call. Jobbler is this standard length. And it's 118 degrees cutting lip and point, all right? They also sell something called a split point. That is where the point is split, and it's a 135 degrees grind. So what that means is it's like having a center drill tip. A center drill is what you use to pre-drill your hole so this drill does not walk. And that has a split point, which is 135 degrees, the grinding. These are your standard, it's 118 degrees. These can walk on you. When you're drilling in metal, they'll walk. Now, again, these drills are meant for metal. They're not meant for wood. But can you use it for wood? Yes. You can't use it on concrete. Can you use it on concrete? Yes. You're going to damage the drill. Just know that. All right. So, like I said, 3/8. That's 375. Oh, something else. This is a full drill set. Drills come in three sizes. You have your decimal or number size. It's a number. You have your letters sizes. They're all alphabetical letters. And you have your fractions. Your fraction drills here. See? Fractions. And then, again, you'll have your metric. So, you could say they come in four different sizes. Number, letters, fractions, and metric. Alright? So, my advice to you, if you're going to buy any kind of drill, make sure it's made in the USA. Why? Because when you buy USA made, they're made with good quality steel. It's the steel that makes the drill. It's not the grinding, because the Chinese do a very good job in China and grinding. The Chinese problem has always been the material. But under Bush, when he released the tariff, took out the tariff on the Chinese were buying all the steels. This is back in the 1996. And that's when you probably noticed, junk for cars. They're junking your cars, buying all the steel. U.S. companies like myself were having a hard time buying steel because the Chinese were buying everything. They were building the Olympics, and they were buying all the steels, even the junk cars. Some of you guys are old enough might recall that. But like I said, these are high-speed steel drills. They're made out of high-speed steel. And this one is non-coated. And then you have your black oxide. It's these. And you see here, the black oxide. It's just a coating to make the cutting tip last longer. You also have nitrate coating, which is a gold color. So, there you go. This is the drill set. These are called auger screws. They're not bolts, because bolts have threads on them. These are wood threads. So that's what makes these screws, auger screws, for drilling in wood. Again, refresher right here. These are dial calipers. They're not veneer calipers because they have this dial. If you like, I go more into details about this. I already have a video how to read your dial caliper. Not only read it, how to buy it. See, a lot of people, they understand this. They think they understand it, but they don't, because they buy the wrong kind of calipers. If you're going to buy this, you want to buy with the carbide tips. You see, carbide tips. And the reason for that is because you measure millions and thousands and times metal touching metal. It wears out your jaws, you see. And when you buy the cheap ones, they're just a high-speed steel. They wear out. And when they wear out uneven, and then they don't give you an accurate reading. See? So that's why I recommend and I tell you to buy the carbide tips. Carbide tips here, carbide tips. This is for OD reading. This is for ID reading. And this is for depth. The depth of the hole, how deep you want to go. See, if you want to measure this depth from the top, it's approximately 1 5/8, 1 inch 625. You have to also measure it like this. But that's what it is. This also has a step from this edge here to here. It's a step. And say you want to measure how step from this shoulder to here, you put this up against there and then buck this part up against here. And that will give you the step. All right. So again, if you were going to buy these are Michitoya. You want to buy Michitoya. Don't buy Sterrett. Don't buy Brown and Sharp. All right. Why? Because Brown and Sharp and Sterrett, you're buying and you're paying for the name. Sterrett, you're paying for Brown and Sharp. They're good quality instruments, but like I said, you're paying for the name. These are Michitoyas. These are the top of the line. These are the Cadillac of the industry. You don't have to buy Sterrett or Brown and Sharp. These are made in Japan, I believe. Yep, they're made in Japan. You want to make sure they're shockproof. You want to get the 1000 calibration. I mean 1000 increments. And like I said, with the carbide tips. I don't know if you can see, get a good look at the carbide tip right there. So there you go. Alright, and like you see, I always keep my tools in the case. Here's, well, you can't see it anymore. The case has seen better days. But look, a lot of you guys use this and you put it on the table where it picks up dirt and chips and everything. That's why they give you the plastic case. This is a good case. You use it, you put it back in the case, and you close the lid. Now dirt and chips cannot fall in there, you see? I see it. About 99% of you guys that know how to use this, you leave it on the table, you leave it on top of the headstock on the lathe, you leave it on the mill, collecting dirt, chips, oil, instead of putting it in the case. All right, so there you go. You learn about drills, the different sizes. You learn about the tip, the grinding tip. It's two different kinds. You have your standard 118 degrees and your split point, which is 135. You learn about the coating. This is high speed, no coating. This is high speed with black oxide coating. There's a gold color one, which is called a tin coating, tin nitrate coating. And all that does, all the coating does is prolong your cutting lip, your cutting edge. All right, so there you go. I'm just gonna be drilling some holes, putting these in there with a socket. Remember what size socket that was? Put it in the comment if you remember, or you're gonna have to rewind it. All right, so that's gonna be this. Nice, short, sweet. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to hear more. If you don't, then I won't be making more. And tell me about the new camera and the audio. All right, like I'm using a Rode boom mic, what they call. And tell me how it sounds, all right? Because this whole video was not done on the cell phone, all right? So let me know. All right, this is Jay from Skunk Works. I was gonna say Blue Garden, but hey, that's another channel. All right, bye. All right, so here, let me show you. Remember I told you this is a 916? Anyways, we got, this is called, I like to get a 916 socket, okay? And this is a 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, yeah, this is called 12 points. Someone has 6 points. So each one of those is called point, and this is a 12 point socket, 916, to see right there. All right, this is called a ratchet. And this is a half inch ratchet right there. And here's your gear shifter. So you go clockwise or counterclockwise to tighten and loosen. And again, this is a 916 12 point socket with a half inch drive. Now these come in many different sizes. You can get on a quarter inch, 3/8, a half inch. So they go in just like this, snap, and then you just tighten it. So this is how we do that. So basically, all right, let me see, I'll show you that like that. Here's another drill I had to find. Now this is called, again,
it's 118 degrees.
This is what they call a silver dimming. Silver dimming, it just means the flute right here is undercut. You got a half inch shank. And I didn't make up the names, they're called silver dimming. All right, this is a black oxide, high speed steel. It even got flats for holding them. And again, only by American, US made. Why? Because the steel will last so much longer. All right, so there you go. So this is basically just a screw job now. You just screw it in. Now we had to drill an oversize, so I had to get the socket inside the hole. I don't know if it's showing over here. Where? Right there. Way in the end there. See? So we had to get the socket in there. And let's see if I could do this one to show you. Now it's tight, and that's what you kind of want, because if it's loose, then you're defeating the purpose of doing this. Having sucking in the bottom board to the top one. So if it's loose, there's no point in it. It's not grabbing. If it's tight, then you're grabbing it. And it just takes a while. Again, you got your drill here. Now, I'm a Milwaukee guy. Milwaukee is heavy duty because the brushes and the motors are wound heavy duty with a copper wire. That's the difference between your drills. The one you buy in Harbor Freight or the Milwaukee up against the DeWalt, or even the blue one, the Makita. All right, so what's the difference between it? Well, on the yellow ones, which is I just said it. What's the yellow one? Well, DeWalt's. The DeWalt's. Those are light duty. And those are good for, you know, home consumers that do not constantly put stress on it. The Makita is the second one, meaning it's a little bit better than your DeWalt's. And it's more for light duty. And the Milwaukee, well, this is heavy duty. This is for construction. It's constantly running, constantly on. That's why the motor, they use a thicker wire. And it's the wire that can maintain more heat. And that's what you're paying for. The brushless motor, the wires that they use to wrap it. That's why Milwaukee costs more than all three of them. So if you're going to be in construction or be doing this 8 hours a day, I would So just pay the extra money and go with your Milwaukee. If you go with the Makita, you're going to overheat it. You're going to have to stop and rest for hours so it to cool down. The DeWalt, same thing. You know, have to rest and let it cool down. Because none of these tools work. They don't work hot. They shut off. They have an automatic heat shut off. So here, we're almost there. Just go a little bit deeper than I wanted to, but you see that, how it's flush? And let's see here. We can see it here. If it's flush there, you see how it's gripping all this? And that's what I want. I want this bore to be sucked up into here. Because it's only glue. So I got the protection of the glue and the bolt. You need to see how much of that bolt I have engaged. Alright. So I'll just go a couple notches down and then that's it. We're done. Alright. So there you go. It's flush here. See? So it's it flush on the ground. And we have this much threaded into our 3x3. And we're supported by the 2x4s. Alright, so there you go. So now you learn about socket, a ratchet, the size. Here's a wrench. You can see the wrench cannot reach in there, but I was correct with the size, 9/16. Our drill, this is a silver demi. And this is the drill for this tap, but I need a bigger size drill to make sure that the socket fit in there. See, and I have to go below it, or else, you know, it cannot reach it. See that? There you go, thank you.
I'm a machinist, a skilled worker. That's who I am. I operate the tools that shape the metal. Like a masterful plan, I cut, grind, and shape, and drill. Precision is key in the manufacturing world. My work sets the industry free, yeah. My work sets the industry free. 'Cause I'm a machinist, a hard-working man. I make sure the machines run just as they can. I'm the backbone of the factory. The gears and motions keep production running with my skill devotion. Well, I'm the one who keeps it all running. Part of what I do with my hands. My mind is sharp, I've got a strong back and a steady heart. I'm a machinist, a hard-working man. I make sure the machines run just as they can. I'm the backbone of the factory. The gears and motions keep production running with my skill devotion. I'm a master of my trade. Work through the night if that's what it takes. Get the job done, I'm the one who makes the parts right. I'm a machinist and I do it with pride. I'm a machinist, a hard-working man. I make sure the machines run just as they can. I'm the backbone of the factory. The gears and motions keep production running with my skill devotion.
I may not be a singer or a star, but I'm a machinist, and I'll work from dusk till dawn. I'll keep the machines running and the factory humming, 'cause that's what a machinist does, and I'm proud of what I become.
Okay, so let me know what you think of the audio, the song, not the video. What is your opinion on the song? Do you like it? Write in the comment, yes, and what you like about it. Or if you don't like it, write in the comments, I don't like it, and why. All right, this is a participation. Thank you for participating.